please fill out a connection card. Let that be your offering today. And know that your presence with us is a blessing to us. And we know that you're blessed by being with us today, because today is a very, very different kind of day. It's going to be a lot of fun. And we're excited about that. We've got several announcements I need to make first. Normally, first Sunday is Communion Sunday. We're not having communion today because that will be next Sunday. We'll see why in a minute. But next Sunday, we'll be celebrating in communion. But also want to let you know some of the other things that are happening. First off, the flowers today are given by the Desouches in honor and in memory of Ryan Desouches' birthday, which is today. And Cheryl has proclaimed it National Pug Day because Ryan was such a pugger. And one of the things when I saw her mention that, one of the first things I thought of was one of the deputies right after the accident. He told us, I've watched that kid grow up. Always that big old pug. Memory recall. Cheryl has announced that this National Hug Day hugs somebody in memory of Ryan. He was a great man who did a lot of hugging around here. Also, I wanted to know several other things that are going on. Blood drive is this Wednesday evening here in our family night supper. We're going to 4-7. If you haven't signed up, there's still space. So you can either call the office to sign up for the blood drive, or you can go online. Go to the Kingsland Methodist site under the blood drive, the bloodline, so they can get some time slotted there as well. Also, I want to remind you to sign up for the family night supper. We need reservations in by noon tomorrow. That way we can have that food. And this week it's preachers who need a new idea, because it's fried chicken. So come on out and be a part of that. A couple of other announcements. Silver Saints, they're meeting this Tuesday at the lunchbox. Be there, then it'll be a lot of fun. Also, tonight we have our district conference. It's the Way Across District Conference. It's the last Way Across District Conference because the way the Southwest Conference is moving the districts around. We're, as of annual conference, which is the 1st of June, we'll be a part of the coastal district. And so everything's changing around, so we're going to be worshiping tonight. And at First Methodist Church, we'll be Way Across. Also, I want to remind folks that we have a team that's up at Smith State Prison with the Kairos Weekend, which is like walk the base, but it's taken into the prison. And I'm already thanking you in advance for all the cookies that y'all gave out. I don't know what the count was, and I'm sure Mr. Mack will be up to see that next week as well. Also, the ladies' walk to a base is going on over at the camp. I guess it's the Lions camp, or the Lions has got a lot of walk apart, so be in prayer for all folks over there also. Then another announcement that's going to be a lot of fun is on May 17th from 2 to 4 in the other place, there's going to be a drop-in birthday celebration for Miss Billy Bruce, and they're singing something about 90, and I thought she was turning 19. But they invite you to come out and wish her a happy birthday, even though it's not the later on, that's the time they can get the family together. And so they invite you to come out and be a part of that. They say your presence is what they want, not present. Not the gift, but just you being there. And so you're invited to be a part of that. There's several folks we need to be lifting up in prayer. In your prayer, in your bulletin, there's a list of folks that we need to keep our prayer on the right-hand side. There's a few others I'm going to add to it. Steve Warren, he came home yesterday, right? He didn't get to come home. Okay, so we need to keep on praying for him and all the stuff that's going on with his lung. Also, Darlene Bruce, her father, is going into for surgery. He's having gallbladder issues, so please be in prayer for him. Also, little Katie Hoffman, one of our little ones, she's dealing with a real bad case of strep throat. And you'll see Brody Siri on the prayer list. He was in the hospital this week with a bad stomach virus that's hitting our children. And so please keep giving our prayers to his twin sister. They're worried about if she's going to get it or not. And the bad thing is start chasing something. So please pray that she'll stay well. Also, we've got some great news, too. Rick and Debbie Mims, our new grandparents. acres, 7 pounds, 4 ounces, 19 3/4 inches long. That's the age. Guys, all 10 fingers, all 10 toes. There's a lot of other things happening in the life of the church, so please check out your bulletins and see where you can plug in. Today, our word of worship you'll find on the yellow sheet because it's very different. We have our children that are bringing the message. Rebecca did such a great job preaching last week, I didn't even follow that. We've got the kids are bringing the message today through their musical, which is from the pit to the palace. And God was thinking about that this last week. You know, that's how God's desire is for us. He wants to take us from the pits of sin and bring us to the pits of power. This is actually the story of Joseph from the pit to the palace. But they'll be blessing us with that in just a few minutes. But our order of worship will come off the yellow sheet. And so let's do what we're coming from. Now, that is to worship Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Y'all know the way I like for us to start out is stand up, greet folks around and tell them how glad you are to be worshiping.
Thank you.
always precious to see them up here because most of y'all don't be up here in one night. It's scary. But, thank you for such a blessing. As we come to our time of prayer this morning, we're here at our waiting prayer as well as offertory, so I want to invite the blessings to come forward. Let's go to God in prayer. Oh Lord, how great it is to call upon your name and know that you hear our prayers. But not only do you hear the prayers of our lips, you hear the prayers of our hearts. For that, we are so thankful. Father, we come to you today. We lift up all of those folks that are on our prayer list. That they're not just names printed in the rules of God, but they're folks that we love, folks that we care about, who are going through different struggles of life. So we pray for your healing touch, God. Where there's physical illness, Lord, we pray for healing of the physical nature, being with the doctors and nurses, and use them to be those instruments of healing. God, where there is emotional healing that needs to take place, we pray that you would put the right people to surround those folks, and Lord, that they would feel your presence with you, and the Holy Spirit would minister to them in that realm as well. Also, for folks who will feel spiritual struggles, we pray for your Holy Spirit. Lord, let them see you in the world in their lives. But for all of these folks, we ask that you just touch them in such a way that they know that you are with them, that you're carrying them through this time. Lord, as we come to worship you today, and also think of those who are here, we ask that your presence be with them. Lord, as we worship you today with these children, we pray that you would bless these children and let them not be fearful up here, but that they would boldly tell the story of Joseph and the greatness that you came to because of your involvement in his life. Lord, we pray that your Holy Spirit would touch us at this time, that we would hear the message that you have for us through this Father, for the tithes and offerings that we lift up to you, we pray your blessings upon them and ask that you use them to further your kingdom so that your light can shine into the dark areas of the
start our children's musical with Hosanna and our Rejoice Choirs. That's our two first grade through fifth grade choirs. And Ms. Adrian leads the Hosanna Choir. Ms. Karen leads the Rejoice Choir. And there's certainly many, many more people I'd like to thank. Ian in the sound booth, Mr. Troy, who put up all these wonderful projections for us. And Ms. Jan, and Ms. Monique, and Ms. Kathy, I have Ms. Peggy, so many others that have helped out through. I'm sure I'm forgetting somebody, but maybe so. we're certainly grateful. The kids got a wonderful message you present. This is kind of different, so there'll be some opportunities for you to respond as well. To shout out things and to clap and to just have a good time rejoicing in the Lord together.
Tonight is going to be exciting as we're celebrating the life of Joseph. Joseph knew God and trusted him. In Joseph's life, we see the God and the character the Lord wants to develop in all of us.
Thank you.
that's Bella, our housekeeper.
Thank you.
remember that God is in control. He knows what you're going through, and you really aren't alone because God is right there with you. Just trust Him, and He'll help you through your pitiful situation.
Situation that is not right. No hesitation. of all that went on in the prison. That's when you met two very interesting people.
Oh, that would be Pharaoh's cupbearer and baker. When we were in prison together, they had strange dreams, and God gave me the meaning of the dreams.
And 2 years later, Pharaoh had strange dreams. Remember this?
It's all
haven't seen them in 20 years. I don't think they recognize me. And look, they're bowing down to me, just like in my dreams. Let's see what they're up to. Stand, foreigners. Where do you come from?
We come from the land of sin. There's a terrible famine there. We came to buy food.
I think you're spies. You've come to see the weakness of Egypt.
No, no, sir. We've only come to buy food.
There are these men, not spies. The 12 brothers.
The 12 brothers, sons of Jacob, great-grandsons of Abraham. Our youngest brother is with our father, but one brother is dead.
Maybe my father still is alive. My brother Benjamin, too. Let's find out. Here's how you can prove you're honest men. Leave one brother here in the guardhouse while the rest of you take grain back to Canaan to feed your families. Then bring your youngest brother back to me. That will prove you're not spies.
Thank you.
question. After all that your brothers did to you, how are you able to forgive them and show them compassion?
I spent a lot of time talking with God about that. He helped me forgive them. God forgives me when I sin against Him, and He expects us to forgive others when they sin against me.
That's hard to do.
But with God, all things are possible.
Well, Joseph, the famine continued, and once again your family came and ran out of food. Your father had no choice. He had to let your brothers take Benjamin back to Egypt. That's when this man became a key player.
Hello, Mr. Joseph. I know you remember me. I was your go-to guy during Operation Give 'Em Grain.
I know that voice anywhere. It's my steward, Stu.
Good evening, Mr. Joseph. I'll never forget the day your brothers returned to Egypt. When you saw them, you turned to me and said, Stu, we're throwing a party. Prepare a feast. Mr. Joseph, when your brothers arrived for lunch and you saw your younger brother, I think he must be a musician. I believe his name is Benjamin.
It's pronounced Benjamin Stu.
Oh, sorry, Mr. Joseph. Anyway, when you saw him, you turned to me and said, you got teary-eyed and had to leave the room. I could tell he was your favorite. When it was time for your brothers to leave for home, you had me set up a little surprise for them. Do you remember what that was, Mr. Joseph?
I certainly do, Stu. Operation Bring 'Em Back. We put the money they paid for the grain back in their sacks, and in Benjamin's sack, we put my silver with a cup.
When they had gone just a short way from camp, you had me go and get them. I had those boys open their bags, and I accused them of being thieves. Don't you know they were shocked?
Yes!
Don't you know they were confused?
Yes!
Don't you know they were scared?
Yes!
Don't you know I locked those boys up in their darkness and turned them right back to Mr. Joseph?
Yes!
And here's what happened next.
You made it, you made it, Almighty God. You made it.
brother Samuel and told me that you were alive. Our family moved to Egypt so that we could be near you, so God could provide for us during the last 5 years of the famine.
Of course, that's my father Jacob.
Son, I was amazed when I learned all that had happened to you, that you were second in command of Egypt. Through all your trials, you trusted God because you knew and understood His command. I am proud of the man you have become today. God has surely done a great work in your life.
Thank you, Father, and thanks to all of you for this wonderful celebration. But all the praise and glory should go to God. God is faithful. He was with me for each step of my journey. He was in control of all that happened. God brought me to Egypt. God blessed me in the house of Potiphar and in prison as well. God sent Pharaoh's dreams and gave me the interpretation. God placed me in command of Egypt, all this to accomplish His plans. But I'm no different than you, just as God did for me. He will see you through every circumstance that comes your way. And more than that, He will bless you and teach you and mold your characters. So know Him and trust Him. And if you're willing, God will give you the privilege of being involved in His plans. He's an all-powerful, all-knowing, ever-present God. Let's praise Him now and forever.
Thank you.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.